Hello everyone. In this video, we will see what is meant by validation dataset. While working with neural networks, we don't know what is the exact architecture of neural network. So we have to start randomly. For training a neural network, we have to decide various things like how many layers will be there, how many neurons will be there in each layer, which activation function will you use in neural network, what is optimizer algorithm you will use in the neural network, which matrices you want to use, and many more. So before training, we have to decide all these things. Such things are called as hyperparameters. Now, ahead of time, we don't know how many layers should be there in neural network, how many neurons will be there in neural network, and so on. We have to perform trial and error method here to understand initially what will be the effect of these hyperparameters on the result. So in order to check the effect of hyperparameters on the result, we cannot use training data, because we have seen that data till now. Our neural network has used that data for learning the approximate function. On the other hand, we cannot use test data. Test data is basically used to understand the neural network evaluation, which is not yet seen by our neural network. So what is the solution? Solution is validation dataset. So from the training dataset itself, we will take out some data as a validation data. This validation data will be used to decide all these parameters. We will keep on performing certain activities like increasing layers, removing some of the layers, and we will check out how it is performing with the unseen data. So in summary, I can say that validation data is used to track how our neural network is performing with current configuration on the unseen data. So let's check out how to use that in coding. We have, now let's observe method signature for model.fit. So here we have one parameter, that is validation split. So validation splits will decide how much data you want to take from training dataset to track the performance of your model on the unseen data. Remember this, this is quite different from the testing data. We are just using validation set to decide the hyperparameters at the initial stage. Okay, so we can use validation split in history is equal to model.fit validation underscore split. Now remember this, out value of validation split must be ranging from 0 to 1. So here I am going to specify 1, then 10% of that data will be taken for the validation. Just execute this cell. Observe this loss and accuracy we are getting for training, and after that we are getting two more values, that is validation loss and validation accuracy corresponding to the validation. Out of this 100% data for training, we are using 10% data for validation. So on that validation data, our neural network will try to predict predictions. Remember this, again, weights will not be updated for validation dataset. It is just used to identify how much our neural network is getting predictions correctly with the unseen data. So let's check out keys present inside the history. We should get four keys: loss, accuracy corresponding to the training, validation loss, validation accuracy corresponding to validation. Now let me draw a line for validation accuracy. So same key I have to use over here, val underscore accuracy. Execute this cell. Okay, now so blue curve is for the training and orange curve is for validation. You can observe that on seen data, like in training case, we are achieving accuracy beyond 99%. But with the validation data set, our accuracy is below 98%. Okay, so our model is going in hand with seen data and unseen data. If this difference is huge, then there is a worry. Okay, and same graph we can use for identifying the bias and variance. How? That we will study in the next video. Coming to the loss, again, let's try to plot a loss for the validation and again, we are going to get two curves. First is for training, that is blue curve, and second is validation, that is orange curve. So again here, validation loss is comparatively high than the training loss. So we can use both these graph for identifying overfit and underfit. Okay, but in summary, I can say that validation is basically used to check how our model is performing with the unseen data. Thank you for watching the video.